Look, the church is losing, and sadly, churches all over the world have become irrelevant in their communities. The reality is that in your neighborhood, the vast majority of churches are barely making it. And if those churches closed their doors tomorrow, most people wouldn't even notice. For years, I've been asking, how did the church get here? Why are so many of our churches empty on Sunday? Where are the young families? How did the church lose its voice? And here's what really gets me. How is it that adults that live in their mom's basement, who post on TikTok or stream on Twitch, have more influence than the church? And now, after working with dozens and dozens of struggling churches over the last several years, the problem has become clear. The problem is leadership. Or, more accurately stated, the problem is a lack of leadership. Here's the deal. Our best leaders, those that have the gift of leadership, the ability to inspire the masses, and the desire to change the world, those people are choosing every profession and hobby but church leadership. And not only are our best leaders not choosing vocational ministry, but there's no bench to fill all the vacant leadership roles being left by the baby boomers that are retiring. Our best leaders, both young and old, are choosing careers in higher education, they're starting companies, or they're pursuing jobs in the public sector. I'm not suggesting those aren't important vocations. They're very important. But what I am suggesting is that for far too long, church leaders have made the following statement. We don't need everyone in the church to step into a leadership role. God wants leaders out in the world too. And look, while that's true, it has resulted in our very best leaders not choosing the pastorate and key leadership roles in the church. Now, here's the good news. We can turn this around. We can turn this around so the church can retake its role and reclaim its voice. But I want to talk to four groups of people right now. Four groups of people that will influence the direction of the church for generations to come. And here's the first group. It's parents. Parents, you play an incredibly important role. Here's what I want you to do, parents. I want you to let your adult children say yes to Jesus. Stop holding them back so they can live out your dream. Please stop influencing them towards a life of safety and comfort. And instead, encourage them to go and lead the church into the future. You know, I've discipled a young guy for the last few years. He is dynamic. He's absolutely magnetic. The reality is that people are drawn to him. I started to sense that God was calling him into vocational ministry, perhaps even to the pastorate. He affirmed that calling and his community affirmed it too. But in the end, he was afraid to talk with his parents. He knew his parents wanted him to get a job that paid really well and had a big title. So parents, I'm pleading with you, release and ultimately encourage your kids into the work of ministry. The church must be led by our young people who know how to relate to the upcoming generations. If our young people do not fill the leadership gap in the church, then what kind of community will your grandkids grow up in? And ultimately, who's going to teach our kids and our grandkids for generations to come the truths that only come from the Word of God? Okay, second group of people. It's teens and young adults. I want you guys to listen. Jesus is calling some of you to pick up your cross by pursuing a life of leadership in the church. Many of you want to start a business or a nonprofit focused on a cause that you're passionate about. And man, I love that. And I love your burden to make this world a better place. I really do. I want you to know that I believe in you and I believe in your generation. You guys are changing the world in the most incredible ways. But I don't want you to just make the world better. I want you to lead this world to be its best by loving, serving, and worshiping Jesus. Listen, a life in ministry definitely has its ups and its downs. But there's nothing like getting a front row seat to seeing lives changed forever by the good news of the gospel. Here's my bottom line for you guys. You are the key to filling the leadership gap and revitalizing the church all around the world. All right, third group of people, half-timers, my brothers and my sisters. Some of you that are watching right now, you're like me. You're a half-timer in life. And your soul has been yearning for purpose and meaning. That's right, I am talking to you. Some of you are growing weary of sales calls, negotiating deals, and the bottom line mentality. I've been there. God has put something in you that makes your heart beat for the work of ministry. But the reality is you're scared. You're afraid to take the ministry pay cut or to start all over. And many of you feel like you're not qualified. As a fellow half-timer, I can only tell you my experience. When I said yes to Jesus and stepped into a role that He was calling me to, God replaced all of my fears with overwhelming blessings and a life that I don't feel worthy of. Look, I get up every single day and I go to work and do my life's work, serving and leading in the local church. Now, for these leaders, our teenagers, our young adults, and our half-timers to step into these critical leadership roles in the church so we can turn the church around, something very important needs to happen. So I want to talk to the fourth category of people, because without you, we cannot right the ship. Here we go, the fourth category. It's pastors, elders, and church members that are in control of churches that are struggling and closing. You need to let go. You have clenched your fist around something that simply is not yours. The church doesn't belong to you, just like it doesn't belong to me. God called you and He called me to steward what is His. And now, for many of you, it's time to gracefully hand over the building and the people to a leader that's called by God to reach the next generation. Look, so many church buildings are falling apart. There's no kids running through the halls and no one's coming to faith in Jesus. It's time for a new leader with a vision and a passion to make the necessary changes so that the church, your church, can once again thrive and fulfill its God-given purpose. Now, I want to say this to you, those pastors, those elders, and those members, those of you that are in control of these churches, I want you to know that you are revered, you are deeply loved, and your contribution to the church has been profound. But for some of you, there's no better way to express your love for Jesus right now than to invite the next leader of your church to step into your role. And I believe that as you trust God, He will not only provide for you, but He will give you a greater sense of purpose in your next season of life and your next season of ministry. Now, let me pivot for a moment. I want to share a little something about me. 10 years ago, the publicly traded company that I worked for handed me two large stock awards. They're not stock options, but they were stock awards. And I'm going to translate that. That means free money. Stock awards are free money. The stock awards were worth enough money to send my kids to college. But soon after I got those, I received a call from my pastor that would change my life forever. My pastor said he was opening up a job that he thought I should pray about. And to be honest, I was scared. I felt unqualified. I'd worked so hard for my reputation, my title, and those stock awards. And who in their right mind would throw away a gift of a whole bunch of money, right? So my wife and I had the decision of our lifetime in front of us. We talked, we prayed, and we wrestled with God. Oh man, did we ever wrestle with God. And right now, many of you that are listening to this, teens, young adults, and half-timers, you have the decision of a lifetime in front of you. Are you going to step forward and lead the church out of irrelevancy and into relevancy? Are you going to be a part of the solution, changing the trajectory of the local church in your community to reach the generations to come? So, to the teenagers, the 20-somethings, and the half-timers, My challenge for you is simple. I want you to trade in your equity for eternity. That's right. I want you to trade in your stock awards, your equity positions, and your causes for the eternal work of leading the local church. I'm challenging our best leaders to sacrifice a life of comfort and stuff for a life of being used by God to transform the church and to ultimately transform lives. As I said, 9 years ago, I got an offer to help our pastor lead the church. My wife and I had a choice: stock awards or eternal rewards. And look, in the end, our decision was this. We accepted the job to serve and lead the church, and we turned down those stock awards. It turns out the hardest decision I've ever had to make was the best decision I've ever made. I wake up each and every morning, and I want to run to work. I don't want to walk. I want to run to work. Why? Because I get to do my life's work. I get to do the things that God put me on this earth to do. You see, in the end, I don't feel like I made a sacrifice to help lead the church. No. Instead, I feel like God blessed me with an incredible opportunity to serve the church. Again, here's my call to you as a leader. I want you to trade in your equity for eternity.